It's a bit gloomy outside for a July afternoon. I've been meaning to show you guys homemade tomato sauce, and this is the quick cooking method, which I really like the best, although some tomato sauces are finely milled and cooked a long time, like sauce bolognese. But this one is, I learned this in Italy when I was a student there, and on many subsequent visits, I've learned a lot of Italian cooking in Italy, which is a joy. These tomatoes are fully in season, and they were practically giving them away. They are so sweet and nice. I've been slicing and serving them absolutely plain with meals. But there are so many, and they were just ready to go. I said, we're having the spaghetti with fresh spaghetti sauce tonight, and he was fine with that. He likes it. I'm sorry. Spaghetti is actually not good for meat sauces because it's too thin and the meat cannot cling to it. That kind of a sauce can't cling to it. There are other pastas which are better adapted for a good sauce bolognese. And they might be fettuccine, for example, or tagliatelle, or those macaroni with the little grooves on the side, and so on. Every pasta shape, the reason they do that is because it's for a reason. These were boiled, put into boiling water, and then continued to boil until the skin split. And they don't split at the same time, and it's kind of boring because some of them are really stubborn. I don't know why. They can be perfectly ripe and wonderful. Like this one didn't split quite enough, but I don't think it's going to be a problem. So you have to take them out one by one and put them somewhere until they cool to the point where you can handle them. Then you can slip off the skins, peel them off quite easily. You can take off the stems, maybe take out a little bit of the core if it's very coarse. And then just like quarter them and put them in a colander and squeeze them a bit to get those seeds out because they're very bitter. Put in some fresh basil if you have it. Coarse salt and maybe a little bit of ground pepper and let them drain in the colander for a while. And then I see some splatter here on the tile. That's no good. And then I rinse off the salt. If there's any fresh basil in there, I leave it in there. I don't want all that salt in there. I discard the water. Oh, I steamed up my lens. And that's giving it the Penthouse magazine effect. Then I can heat some olive oil in a pot, such as an Italian pasta pot, you know, down on the bottom. I think I'm going to use the cocotte, though. This is a French-Dutch oven. And a crushed garlic clove. And maybe a few red pepper flakes or something like that. And I actually have some mild peppers here, and this one is very pretty. And it looks pretty advanced. You know, it's ready to rock and roll, so some of this might go in there or something like that. A little hot pepper, but very little. And I don't think I'm going to need any sugar for these. They're already so sweet, but for the rest of the year and for less sweet tomatoes, you might need just a pinch of something sweet. And then you cook the sauce, and it's chunky for only 14 minutes. It's a fast cooking sauce. The pasta is cooked then while you're doing that. The correct way, please. you know, use Italian method, and whether it's fresh or dried pasta, please cook it correctly. And it's very nice on a hot plate, which has been rubbed with a garlic clove, and perhaps some little cubes of mozzarella cheese in the middle, if you have them. And then you put the pasta down, and then you put the sauce over it. And if you want grated cheese, which my spouse refuses to eat with pasta, you serve that on the side, which is how they do it in Italy anyway. And you never, ever have cheese on pasta with seafood. If the Italians see you doing that, they won't say anything, but they will wince. You can see them wince. That's highly incorrect. Of course, in your home, you can do whatever you want. If you know how to prepare squid, these can be prepared and seared separately and added in because you want to take them out so they don't get rubbery quickly. Add them in the last minute of cooking with the sauce if you want some, for example, some squid in your sauce. But it's a really fast cooking sauce, and I just cannot describe how good it is. And once you have this, you will not be able to be very happy with prepared stuff in a jar or anything, or a can or whatever. And of course, you can use this method, and if you want a coulis de tomate, you know, really a fine tomato sauce, at that point, without the squid, obviously, you could run it through one of those hand food mills or something. I used to do that. It's very, very good for lasagna. And that is lovely because that refines it further. But this is excellent. I really look forward to making this when I can get my hands on a whole bunch of tomatoes. And it does take a while. It takes a long time to, you know, boil the water, get the skins to split. They won't split at the same time. You have to let them cool. There are a lot of steps to this, but it's only 14 minutes of cooking time. And people go bananas for this at the table. And I really suggest you learn how to cook pasta correctly, the Italian method. I may do a clip on that, but I don't promise it. So have a good time if you try this, and I believe you will like it. And it's a great thing for damaged tomatoes, tomatoes which are past their prime, or which are actually inferior. You know, they just don't have much flavor or anything, you know. It's just really worth the effort. Okay, see you later. Bye.